This stupid thing, it don't want to play nice. You don't need to see the screen. That's number one. And number two, you don't need to be so freaking... Stop being so down. Stop being so damn. You certainly don't need to see that. That. And what's back there? What's back there? You see what's back there? I was able to finally pull the damn thing out. Some freaking shit going on with it. But, as far as I know, the amp is fine. It's great. But, didn't turn out to be the deal. Didn't turn out to be the deal I was kind of hoping for. And I think there's something wrong with like three of the speakers. Because one of them is definitely the loudest. And then the other three, like, I disconnected them and I ran them through. And there's something, like, really, they sound flat. They don't sound like they're blown, like, they sound like shit. But they don't sound like they should sound. Let's put it that way. And I just wasn't in the mood to start tearing shit apart like I always do. So I threw, so I just pulled out the cords and I jacked the cabinet in. And the cabinet's freaking doing fine. I mean, I bought it for the amp. I didn't really buy it for the cab, to be honest with you. That's how I feel about it. I'm like, I'm not going to freaking worry about that shit. I got plenty of fucking cabs. Seriously. So, that being said, it's a blues. I really should check that out too, because hang on one second. Let's check this out. Yeah, see, it's like I thought. There's like no identifiable markings on there except for the serial number. Do you know what I mean? That would say if it was a 3 or whatever. I know they've been out for a while. I know the 410 has been out for a while. And it does have the reflective plate as opposed to the black plate. And so that's like, you know, that's a what? Post 210, I think. I'm not really sure. Don't really know. I'm not a freaking expert on these shits because don't really know. Like I told you guys, I just came back into this fold of playing and goofing around with this shit. What, 2 years ago? A year ago? 2 years ago? Well, seriously, like a year ago, because after everything got serious, I was just like, fuck it, you know, and this is what I'll do. I'll go out happy. You know, hang out, have as much time with my little one as possible, and then the rest of the time just fucking go out happy. So that's the way I'm gonna do it. You know, and then dealing with insanity, all, you know. But I gotta, I'm really, really, really bad. Just when you think, you know, you're done with all the bells and whistles and freaking howdy doody bullshit, it gets freaking nuts. It gets really nuts. I don't know how well this is gonna look on there. It didn't look too bad when I showed it to you last time. So let's see if I can call it up. I hate falling in love. I really do. No. Why is it there? I don't understand why it's there. Oh, I gotta find this damn thing. Hold on 1 second. My daughter's like, you never freaking run in and out of the goddamn thing when you're recording. I'm like, well, it's been a lot of freaking shit going on. You know, and just, you know, I don't know. Oh, there it is. So, let's see if we can lock. We're gonna lock this. And then we're gonna stretch this out. And hopefully, you'll be able to get a good shot of that. Think. I know the neck part was getting is not dark. I mean, you can't really see the neck too well. But let's see if you can get like that. Nah, it's not fucking coming out that right. But what do you think? Is worthy of a freaking acquisition or what? I think it's like $199 or whatever, and I was already making promises and saying that, you know, that was it, because I went and, because what did I do? I went and I picked up the, I fought like crazy, and, fought to pick up the, Mad Professor. Another freaking piece of item that I didn't think I got a great deal on, but I got it for under 100. Which one? The Mad Professor won, of course. I think I liked it. Gino Matteo does a really great review on it, because you gotta like Gino Matteo, because he's a fantastic artist. So everyone else does a review on it, and everybody's got their freaking, you know, they got their Eddie Van Halen freaking hat on, and they're all playing everything, you know, Eddie V. Gino gets on there and he's just like, fuck, wail it. Just wail it. And you're like, oh my God. That sounds... Even he was like, dude. He's like, what the fuck? When an artist does that for an item and you're like, wow. I mean, really. It was, you know, and so it's been out for a while. And I found it on Guitar Center Used. And it seemed like every time I found that son of a bitch freaking somewhere for like $69, you know, $79, it was gone, like, within hours. So if I didn't have the funds, you know, right there to freaking pull it, that was it. That, you know, I missed it. Missed the boat. And I kept missing the boat, missing the boat. I'm like, what the fuck? You know, all the $99 ones were still there, but the ones that were cheaper, gone in an instant. I'm like, that's to do a little more, be a little more proactive. So, I'll take a run down there and, oh yeah, so that's there. And I ordered that yesterday, which means it's not shipping until today, which means it won't get here until today, Wednesday. It'll probably get here by Saturday. So that'll be freaking awesome. Shipping was like $5 and five something. But they charged you tax, man. I'm like, what the fuck are you charging tax for, you cocksuckers? But I mean, seriously. And it was like five and change for fucking tax. I was like, what? Five and change. I was like, this is, it's on the freaking, you ain't right, mother Fletchers. So, this is, as you can see, this is the clean channel. And I jacked in that cabinet and I had this one jacked in, but it's too loud against the mic. The reverb is like on 2, 3. Beautiful. That's dimed. Volume is like on 2. So plenty of freaking volume. I gotta worry about that. Then, you know, it has the drive and the more drive. So you put it on the other channel and you get the drive channel. With the controls and freaking have a ball there. Has an effects loop and everything like that. So that's that. And here's the more drive. Well, that was the more drive, sorry. Thank you. not nearly as bassy as this amp, but I haven't totally freaking, you know, played with the dials and the tunings and all of that crap, and I don't have the other thing hooked up there. There's two inputs, so you can hook up an internal and an external. It's set up for 8 ohms, so whatever you can pile on there at 8 ohms. I don't know, I don't have the manual, so I don't know how far she can go on 4 ohms, so I don't, I'm not sure what to do there, but I'm already crazy thinking about putting it into a different freaking because, you know, it's like if you freaking change the chassis or whatever, you know, people get all freaking bent out of shape if you want to resell it and stuff, which I don't know if I will, but I'll pull the whole freaking guts out and everything like that and transfer it into another freaking cabinet. That I'll do. So I was debating on whether to put it in into the black cabinet or put it into the black cabinet or put it into the freaking other cabinet, the boombox cabinet. Or just build a hot rod cabinet, you know, and use the same plates. I'll use the same plates because what the hell is the purpose? I mean, you know, what's the sense of freaking changing the same, you know, changing the back plate? It's already freaking cut out for you, and it's all surface mount. I mean, really. So, and it's big, it's big there, but it's thin. The back plate. I don't know. Seemed easy. Didn't really have to go through it much of anything. Didn't check the bias of on it or anything like that. I'm sure I really should. Because God only knows what's in it. At this point. Takes the pedals great. Tweak the fucking pedals to compensate for it. Not too much with those two, though. You hear the hum? To freaking, I don't know what the fuck to play. So I like it so far. It's not, you know,
thank you.
All right. Now it's, you know, just about getting used to it, you know, because otherwise it's all for nothing, for really. I mean, you really got to hear this fucking thing, though.
It's quite interesting.
Oh, I really can't complain, and I really won't complain. Paid fairly what the going price is. It was like $450 if you found it out there. Okay to me, I ain't got no problems with it. But like I said, I'm, you know, got to conserve on space and whatnot, so I'm thinking of building a freaking, either just popping it into a 2x12 cab, one of the small short 2x12 cabs, or I mean, this thing freaking weighed a ton. I mean, for me, it weighed a ton. Normally, 4x10's not a big deal, and I have a set of 4x10's that are I have in a Marshall, but that thing is sitting out in Oklahoma somewhere, and it's gonna be a while before I take a drive out there. A couple of months, and then went over $30 for a freaking eminent speakers. So I already have the freaking cabs. What do I need more for? So if I build a head, it's gonna be like almost 14 inches deep because it's this way, right? You have the amp, which is about this big, and then you have the freaking tubes, right, which is about that. I'm going to say it's about 14 fucking inches. Definitely 14 inches just for clearance, right? So that's... And it sounds like an amp. I mean, really, it does sound... Compared to the PV, it's fine. Sitting there in the store, and I'm freaking... And I'm playing the goddamn thing, and I have it on 2. Ah, it's loud. And all of a sudden, I'm playing with it, and I can't remember what channel I was on, but I just did something... And I was like, oh my god, this thing sounded amazing. And, amazing. And I was like, holy crap. So I wasn't even thinking about how it would sound with the freaking cabs. But that. So, I don't know. What do you think? Do you have one? I mean, you know, what do you compare it to? It has a lot of bite. It's not a metal, although it is classic. Classic rock, definitely. It does classic rock, no problem. But metal, the pedals will freaking push it. And if I put it on clean and then dial that freaking other crazy pedal a little bit, I can push it a lot. But she's got a lot of dirt. She's got a lot of crunch, and I'm extremely freaking happy with it. And then we got to see what happens with that Mad Professor. Right? That'll be freaking amazing. And it brought this into that Fendery. Complaints, man. Thank you. Whatever. Sounds different with the other freaking cabinet, right? And that's just, you know, that's just the full complement of four speakers. So, can you imagine if I hooked up all fucking eight speakers? Holy shit, forget about it. So, that's my little ta-rah update. And I guess I'll fucking get back to you guys as soon as I figure out what... You see, now is this all whacked out? It's all whacked out. I don't understand. Why is it so whacked out? Nah. I don't know. A lot of stuff went down over the last week, and a lot of it was pain in the ass. Good stuff, you know, the deck is done. And a few things to do here and there. And we got through it. The Pope is coming. So everybody had to freaking jet out of here because they're closing up freaking all kinds of areas in New York and stuff like that. So my family was like, fuck this, we're out of here. So I was like, all right, safe home. And it took them a while, but they got it home. They got home and everything. So that's that. I still have a few freaking videos that I had done, including a midnight one. Where I plugged in the Pandora and just had a ball with that damn thing. And that was cool. And it sounded really good. I mean, if I want to do freaking crazy shit in the middle of the night, I could do crazy shit in the middle of the night. And I did with everybody here. And I was just like, check this shit out. And nobody fucking could hear nothing. So I was like, yeah, I'll work with that. By the way, it's not mic'd up. I didn't mic it up to anything just now. So you're hearing everything through this goddamn thing. I will talk to you people later, and let me know what you're doing, you know, new equipment, or whatever you're doing, and everything like that. I haven't touched Pony Boy because, you know, company. So, but it's been crazy. Oh, yeah, and I found out yesterday that a friend of mine who I met back in 2013, Debbie Constantino, she freaking passed away, her husband. This guy Mark, man, freaking... I don't know. I had nothing really to say to him. I wanted to, but he didn't seem very approachable. Fucking asshole, man. He fucking killed himself and he killed her. So it was like a double... I can't even say it's a double. It was a murder-suicide. So, I don't know. Fucking asshole. But there was a bunch of stuff going on around, and I think that that had a lot to do with it. You know, and he was always one who wasn't into freaking protection and stuff like that. And he's messing around with EVPs big time. And they had some serious freaking shit going on around there in their, where they lived. Paranormal shit. And they were getting attacked left and right. So, I mean, and she let me in on a lot of freaking stuff that was going on. I don't know, man. She was just open like that, you know, once she found out who I was and everything, we got to talking. So I told her, I says, you know, just find me, contact me, let me know what's going on and whatever. She never did, and now they're dead. And and that's sad. It's really sad. Anyway, God rest in peace, Debbie, and hopefully your soul is freaking... Mark, your soul is at peace, and you know, hopefully you can find some solace in this insanity that you freaking had to put yourself through. Laters. That's all I gotta say. Peace. Have a good one. Love you.